Known as having the world's worst weather, Mount Washington is always a location that stands out on our weather maps, and rightfully so. At over 6,000 feet, Mount Washington is the highest peak in the Northeast and goes through drastic changes season to season.
Anytime we have a lot of icing events, frozen precipitation, freezing rain, glaze ice, sometimes we can get inches and inches of it per hour, which does a lot of damage to some of our instruments.
It's hard work living there, but it's paid off over the years. They didn't know how important it would be to start gathering data in 1935, but as it turns out, it's incredibly rare to have hourly observations at that altitude.
This was August of 1935.
We definitely rely on our data set, which now at 90 years is getting on to longer than a lot of people live.
Coupled with detailed data from Pinkham Notch, Mount Washington is being looked at very carefully by the scientific community to better understand the magnitude of the warming aloft.
Up here are all of our wind instruments. I got three anemometers and two wind vanes up there.
Not only is the world's worst weather a chiseling of weather instruments or spring's high winds, it is a treasure trove of weather data that not only helps this daily weather forecaster with forecasting the weather, but also helps research where the weather is headed in our future.
Georgia Murray, a staff scientist at the Appalachian Mountain Club, released a study recently that showed while most of us that live below 6,000 feet have felt the warming, the rock pile in nearby Pinkham Notch have been exempt up until about 20 years ago.
When we look at annual temperature trends, our paper found that actually for the first time, the summit is tipping to what we call significantly warming.
Over nine decades, Mount Washington is showing a tenth of a degree increase per decade, most of it occurring from late winter into early spring.
We have looked at that and are seeing some indication that the rate of warming is speeding up in the latter half of the record.
And it isn't just the temperatures. Several other trends are being seen that indicate a weakening winter season up there.
So we found that the growing season is extending by 15 to 33 days. 15 for the summit and 33 days. That's huge. We also found that we're losing cold conditions, those frost days, 15 to 18 fewer days.
Due to the strong winds in the winter, hurricane force winds average once every 2 days, it's hard to quantify snowfall changes because a lot of it is blown off the mountaintop.
One of the take homes from looking at all of those climate indicators is that all of the seasons are being impacted.
Yes, throughout the Earth's history, climate is always changing, but it is to understand what it is doing now that can allow us to forecast the future. Atop Mount Washington, Kevin Skorupa, WMUR News 9.